So this was where the sun was setting yesterday. And if you look around here, this is where the sun is rising this morning. This is 6:22. And there's again a train coming, 3°C. So this is nearly freezing here. This is absolutely cold. And it was absolutely cold here in the tent. And with the train, when the train is honking here, it sounds like you are sleeping beside the train here. But it's okay, it was only one time in the night. And now there is some breakfast here. Some rice. I don't know what the compagnon is doing here, but it will, I think, taste delicious. And then we wait for the sun, or I wait for the sun. I had a shower there. The shower was excellent, hot. And there's the sun really soon coming, and then with the mighty radiation, everything gets better. 3°C. So the Fahrenheit is 35 currently, 35 only. Yeah, and we go there in the mountains now to Sequoia National Park is today on the plan. And after our breakfast, we go there in this direction where you can see the mountains here. So we are driving now. 25 children are present. Okay. To the Sequoia National Park. It looks really green here, everything, huh?
Exeter is a village in Australia, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
This is Exeter in the Central Valley here in California. And it looks really nice for a Californian town here. Yeah, I don't know. It takes now still, I think, half an hour or 1 hour till we are in the Sequoia National Park. And then we are in the mountains. And by the way, we had some breakfast, a little bit unusual breakfast. And it's not visible anymore. I had, what did I have? Tamales. I forgot it, tamales. Was it tamales? I forgot it. Mexican food from a woman sitting in the booth in the corner. Oh, everything dried out here. This was relatively tasty, all this maize food. And with the hot chocolate, which was, it's a thick starch-based chocolate, a food by itself, a meal.
With cinnamon.
And cinnamon, yeah. So you can see it here perhaps. That's getting more hilly. This is the foothills of the Sierra Nevada, and it gets higher then, much higher. Than this, I can even see snow on the top. This is where the name comes from, Sierra Nevada. What's the height? Currently it's 160 meter in height, and it goes up to 3500 meter, and I think even more. We are still early, 8 in the morning, and it's 49 degree Fahrenheit. So this is now in the hills here, in the foothills of the Sequoia National Park. And they use fee $5, you need a ticket. And then you can go with your boat here. Your life jacket and go fishing here, for example. There are some people outside, and this is much bigger than it looks like here. It's not so small because it goes left around, then also you're right around somewhere. It's relatively big here. But not so much plants around. So now we are inside the park here. In the beginning, it's the Sequoia National Park. It's one park that I haven't visited yet. 1934, five, I mean. It's already this old, yeah?
Is this?
Huh? The companion ran away. That's currently too much to read for me. American buffalo and the buffalo nickel. So that's one of the first outlooks here. That's a granite rock. Look at this here. They are relatively big, these trees. But everything burnt down here. Was perhaps it looks like last year, not too long ago. This looks here a little bit better now. So there's snow on the top here of the mountains, but look at this side here. That's an amazing view here, and here it goes down. And it goes absolutely steep down, so if you roll here down, then you fall into death here below. There's no fence like in Germany. And here on this side, there's everything burnt down, and here it goes up safely on this granite rock. So that's now the top here. It's Morro Rock. And this is where we came from. This is Central Valley there behind. There's even the lake, and then there's a road winding up here. And this is where we came. And we are going further this way here, and then I think somewhere around here over the top, and then somewhere more north. And it's currently it's only around 0 degrees Celsius, 35 degrees Fahrenheit. Well, there's really snow here. There are some remains still of snow here lying around, even in this height. Nice scenery. Nice scenery. So here you can see the giant trees. The huge diameter. There's the companion showing you the tunnel lock where you can drive through with your car. What's on the other side? And this tree fell in 1937. That's really a long time. That's nearly 100 years lying around here. Where are the other trees then? Which must be lying around here. They are removed perhaps. And let's go perhaps to one of these bigger trees a little bit closer. And these are not the biggest, you can see them here in the distance also. (Clears throat)
I need the companion for hate comparison. Oh, there are some lying around. So the companion is now there for hate comparison. I don't know if you see the companion, but you see the tree. The companion is so small there. It's unbelievable how large they are. The companion. There are many people walking here around. I don't know why there is always here, but this is every 10 years perhaps a fire here.
This is very common. It's map, I read it on the map.
It's the fire, it's yes. Very common, yeah.
It's very common that young sequoias do have such burnings. It's
young?
Very common, yeah.
Why? Maybe it's snow. On the other side is snow here. It's completely covered in snow here. The other side. Jesus. Oh, what a bird. On this side, no one is walking. You can see this in the snow. That's the big tree trail where we are walking. And this is a... Oh no, it goes on the right side. There's a toilet going. It's a little bit cold here. But then I can prepare for the night already. Big trees trail, this direction. Jesus, is this big? These are more than, this looks more than one, even two trees.
What means that? Collecting water, too wet for trees to grow.
Ah, this is here in the middle.
Oh.
That's too wet for trees to grow. Need enormous amount of water. If you have nothing to prepare, it looks really small, but this is so huge. Yes. That's unbelievable if you look up. How huge this is here.
It looks really ancient.
In Tasmania they were also very tall.
Yeah.
Even taller than these trees, yeah. But not so wide.
What do you think, how old they are? I read around some of them are over 2,000 years old.
I think some hundred years.
Do you think that's true?
Yeah, could be.
Over 2,000 years.
Could be. So look, the sequoias here, they are clearly visible on the lighter brown branches there. Not branches, bark, I mean. And the other trees are some other pines, pine trees. It's really big, but it's cold. We should walk a little bit faster, I suggest. That's around 0 degrees. You can see the snow here. That's huge. Oh, we can walk inside here. Only a little bit. I have to go to the sun here. This night will be again really cold, but I hope only 3 degrees warmer is the better forecast. Promised. So this one grew somehow around the rock. or the rock fell into the tree, I don't know. This looks really loose. If only the tree holds it in place, the rock. Interesting place here. This is Sequoia. Sequoia place here. I think the trees are not so high, but they are really wide. On the ground, because in Tasmania, there's also the giant gum tree, giant eucalyptus, and they are also really wide in diameter, even like this here. But I think they are even higher. There's nothing really here for comparison, but these are huge here. They're lying around, some of them. By the way, it's getting spring here. All the leaves, like in Germany, when we left Germany, very similar. Last week it was snowing in Germany when we left. 5 centimeters of fresh snow. That's impressive. These giant trees here. So, must now a little bit hurry up here. It's too cold. And then it's lunchtime here in the woods here, where the bears are. The bears, I mean. So here are some younger sequoias, and here are some more older ones here. Oh, there's another description. Surviving change. Wet. So that's now the general Sherman tree, which was once named Karl Marx tree. That's a funny thing. Even a big branch there. You can read the Wikipedia for Karl Marx tree. Funny story. So, it's the biggest tree in volume. It's only in volume, it's not even the height. It's only the mass itself. So that's the Karl Marx tree from behind. And it's really indeed impressive. I hope that there's no branch falling down, because this is the size of a tree. Such a branch. And everyone's staying in front to get the picture there. But here behind, it's much more calm. What are you doing behind me? Well, so we stopped now here on a parking spot. And when we came, everyone disappeared. This is the only car which is left. And look here with the nice river below. And this is still bear country. Nice bridge there, a road where we came from. And there's some benches. There's our cooking procedure. It looks nice. I hope that there's no bear coming with all of our food here, because here Bear. Bear issues.
So we are driving a little bit further in the direction of Kings Canyon, and what you can see here is everything burnt down. Look at this, this was a fire perhaps not long ago. There's absolutely nothing green here. Now this is here green a little bit. But all the trees, nothing green. Really huge damage here everywhere. This black forest here. And now it's green here.
So that's now the Kings Canyon overlook. Not so much to see here. Yeah, it should be really looking nice, but currently this looks not so interesting. Because perhaps it's too cold currently.
So again, a burnt landscape here. Everything burnt down here perhaps last year. Look at this, everything green, black I mean, there's nothing green anymore. And I don't know if they survived here or not. Did they survive? You know this, huh?
Yeah, they survived. Sequoia still survived if they have a certain age.
Okay, but perhaps not every tree here.
No, not every tree. It's true.
This looks really dramatico. So here's a dead rattlesnake. It's a small rattlesnake, but it was accidentally killed by a car, I think, here on the campground today. So there are indeed rattlesnakes running around here. You must be careful about what's happening here.